Looks like they've changed their tactics. But why? Why do this?
It's a message to the entire world that nothing can stop them.
Visual on the mission sites.
We're heading to South Africa for this one, and we need to get down there fast. We've gotten reports of alien activity taking place in a densely populated urban center. We should move to secure the area and minimize further civilian casualties. Solid copy, Big Sky. Strike One has been given the green light. Your highest priority is to protect those civilians.
Eyes open.
This negates any hope we had of establishing a clear pattern of behavior among the alien species. This specimen is nothing like the others.
Seems like they've got one of everything.
Clear. Go. Good to go. Now move.
See you in hell.
Locked and loaded.
As unprofessional as it sounds, the bite seems to have turned him into a zombie.
Enemy in sight.
Flanks. Kill.
Bye-bye.
Everything by the numbers.
Remember, we will be watching.
Satellite coverage.
Commander, we've got another contact. The signature is a little bigger this time, though. I'm sure the troops will be eager to get out there and even up the body count.
I just don't understand. Why use such advanced technology against it?
Contact detected.
Engaging bogey.
Contact detected.
We're in pursuit.
Strike one. Prepare for landing.
We're dropping you just inside the Egyptian border. It looks like the aliens went down in a sparsely populated area. If there are civilians in the area, I hope they stay clear. Affirmative, Big Sky. Strike One is free to engage hostile targets at the crash site.
Thank you. Eyes open.
The target.
Falling back.
Damn it, missed the target.
What's making that noise?
Go time.
They're on the move.
Got a visual. Moving to firing position.
Let's have a peek.
Rack-tack bang.
That looks like the primary power source for the alien craft. I could only hazard a guess as to the amount of power it would have to be generating to propel that ship. I'd watch your fire down there. That equipment could be highly unstable.
Quiet. Did you hear something? What was that?
on target.
The alien flight computer could prove to be extremely useful in our own research. Please take great care in returning it to the base in one piece.
Excellent work. All objectives complete.
Our troops really came through on this one. I'm glad everyone made it back safely.
Several members of the Council have expressed an interest in acquiring some of the artifacts we've recovered. However, we should be careful in choosing what items we release. The research team may not have discovered their true value yet. Our satellite is prepped and standing by for launch. We are ready to deploy it on your orders.
Satellite launched.
Nothing to report at the moment. Boards are clear.
Thank you.
We've made a number of interesting discoveries based on the autopsy results of the alien specimen you brought back. The research team is now referring to this particular variation as a sectoid, based on the unusual structure of its internal organs, which we believe to be the product of genetic manipulation. As we've seen in the field, this species also seems to harbor some sort of telepathic ability. Although I'm sure you can make the connection yourself, we've designated this particular specimen as a floater. The research team is continuing in its efforts to determine how the aliens prevented the organic tissue from rejecting the mechanical components, as they seem to work in perfect harmony with one another. The tall one has, up until this point, been unofficially referred to as the Thin Man. Initial testing has revealed a concerted effort by the aliens to modify this specimen's genetic structure in such a way as to make it appear human. However, on closer inspection, they seem to have had some trouble concealing the eyes, which appear to be reptilian in nature. Based on what we've seen in the field so far, including several grotesque examples of trauma resulting from the emergence of its young, we've taken to calling this specimen a chrysalid.